Now let's look at how the principles of authentication and key exchange that we have discussed are used in actual systems. Kerberos is a standard protocol used to provide authentication and access control in a network environment, typically an enterprise network. Every entity in the network, that is, all users and network resources, such as workstations and printers, have a master key that it shares with the Kerberos servers. And the Kerberos servers perform both authentication and key distribution. So for convenience, we use KDC to refer to a Kerberos server. For human user, the master key is derived from his or her password. For network device, the key is configured in. All the keys are stored securely at the KDC. Now let's go over a few typical Kerberos scenarios. When user Bob logs in, his workstation contacts the KDC with the authentication service request message. The KDC generates a per-day session key, SB, and a so-called ticket-granting ticket that contains SB and ID of Bob. And the ticket is encrypted using the KDC's own key. The KDC then sends back a message to Bob's workstation, and this message is the authentication service response. The message contains the per-day session key and the ticket-granting ticket, and the message is encrypted using the shared master key between Bob and KDC. And because KB is the master key shared between Bob and KDC, only Bob's local workstation can decrypt this message, and then it can store the per-day session key and the ticket-granting ticket. Bob's local workstation will then use SB for subsequent messages with the KDC, and it would include the ticket-granting ticket to remind and convince the KDC to use SB. That is, any new request to the KDC will include the TGT in the request message, and the new tickets from the KDC will be encrypted using the SB. There are several benefits with this scheme. First, the local host does not need to store Bob's password or password hash once Bob has logged in and once he has obtained SB from the KDC. Second, the master key KB that Bob shares with the KDC is only used once every day when Bob logs in initially. That is, the exposure of the master key, which is derived from Bob's password and is subject to password guessing attacks, is very limited.